Crippled by the loss of their supply route, the twin cities of Xiangyang and Fengcheng were ready to fall. The Mongols' new long-range trebuchets would test the mighty walls of the Song Fortress, and Kublai Khan would not stop the bombardment until he sat on the throne of all China. After years of resisting Kublai Khan's siege, Fengcheng and Xiangyang still refused to submit to Mongol rule. To take the cities, Kublai Khan would harness the full power of his empire by enlisting an ally from the Ilkhanate of Persia. Ismail, a siege expert, would lead the Mongol army in the construction of the Huihui Pao, an immensely powerful counterweight trebuchet. This new trebuchet, once constructed, could hurl boulders greater in size than any weapon before it. During the years-long siege, Kublai Khan had established lucrative trade routes with Chinese market towns who swore loyalty to him. Although these trade partners were vulnerable to Song attacks, they could deliver valuable resources to fund Ismail's efforts.
Намига хаш явахгүй бай. Таны хүчийг ясчлан биелүүлсэн. Юу хийж эцлэхгүй.
The Mongol commercial network could supply Ismail in stone so long as he had enough traders on the road.
Ja, wie unik, schau doch mal hier so. You hit it, we over that. I just have it. Other only best. Natura, I just have no breath. Hindered you hit it, we eat
each term.
Be to you got a good barrett or so.
Good sense.
When you're in the cabin, Jimmy from Java. Eat me your homie.
디벳 후대해줘 애님 부친즈 득수 소스트 토다나 빌딩 로샤릭 흑도구 빌드 모에
아직 토야 빌딩
쥬이테
소가라 안하르타 뱀에 인 벨샤가
그러지
남은 하시 올코이 보이
Ich muss wohl.
With the counterweight trebuchet constructed, the Mongols could mount their assault on the twin cities. As Ismail's trebuchet had a far greater range than those of the Song defenders, the Mongols could attack from a safe distance. Drawn to the bombardment from the trebuchet, the Song soldiers left gaps elsewhere in their defense, which the Mongols could exploit. With Fancheng cracked open and the city under active bombardment, the Mongols could now rebuild the bridges that the Song had burned 6 years earlier.
Oh!
Түүнийг удалгүй барай тосгосон.
Эрчүүдээ бэлж. Ушаалыг даг хуя бэлэн. Цааврыг дагагд хуя. Үслэлтийг хороо хангад хуя.
Thank you.
With the bridge rebuilt, the doors to Fancheng were wide open. The Mongols swept into Fancheng, striking down any Song warriors in their path.
Thank you.
After years of holding out against the Mongols, the first of the twin cities finally fell to Kublai Khan's army. All that now stood between Kublai Khan and the throne of China was the final stronghold of the Song, the city of Xiangyang. Using the immense range of the great trebuchet, Ismail aimed to lay waste to Xiangyang's great keep.
I ажиллах уу? Уугал арда ажилдаа бил өмбөгдмөй. Тушаалыг дах хүсэлтийн хороо билэн.
Ismail's counterweight trebuchet proved its might, shaking the earth and shattering the spirits of the Song. The great keep of Xiangyang had fallen. With Xiangyang's gate undefended, the Mongols could now repair the connecting bridge to the Song stronghold.
Зүйтэй, хинд ажил хэрэгтэй. Би замда явж байв.
Тушаа эрчүүдээ зоригтой давших хүй бүгдийг бэлдчихвэ. Биеэ бэлдэл сурыг үзүүлэх. Жирэгт явах. Бүгдийг бэлдчихвэ. Тодан тусгүй.
Үслэлтийн хороо тушаал хүн эмчүүдэ тэднийг бутлэр гэсэн. Хороо тушаал авхуя бэлэн. Тушаалаар болсуу. With the city in disarray, the Mongols were free to tear down the imperial palace. Mongol warriors flooded the streets of Xiangyang as the Song defenders rose to make a desperate last stand.
Okay.
Xiangyang, the great bastion of the Song Dynasty, had fallen. Kublai Khan had finished what his grandfather, Genghis Khan, had started. And now, he could establish his own great dynasty and sit on the throne of all China. The Mongol army smashed through Xiangyang's defenses and captured the city. Kublai Khan then pursued the remnants of the Song dynasty across southern China. In 1279, at the Battle of Yamen, the Mongols destroyed the last defenders of the Song. Kublai Khan now ruled over all China, founding the Yuan dynasty. His royal court in Chengdu welcomed scholars, traders, and religious leaders. The Mongols demonstrated civility and religious tolerance, but also brutality and violence, typifying the contradictions within the Mongol Empire. Since Genghis Khan first united the Mongolian tribes, they had made incredible advances in technology and trade. And they created indelible connections between East and West. At its height, almost 100 million people lived under Mongol rule, a quarter of the world's population. The Mongol Empire endured for less than 200 years before fragmenting into smaller territories, but its legend continues to this day. Genghis Khan's mission was to unite the world into one empire, yet he always returned to the Mongolian steppe. where the endless grasslands lay beneath the eternal sky. And from where he created one of the largest empires the world has ever known.